great distance in education. Indeed, it is common cause that the education system prior to independence has been characterized before as grossly restrictive, racial in practice, and in terms of access as well. It was also limited in terms of skills development and fragmented in structure into African, European, and also the unified teaching services that separated the African teachers and the mission teachers and so on. Through the wise leadership of His Excellency, one unified teaching service was established under the public service system, with the consequent harmonization of teacher education programming and the enlargement of budgetary support for education thereafter. My colleague Minister Mchena has indeed spoken to this effect. This contributed to a robust education system that saw the literacy rate rise over the years to the current levels of 92.4% today, the highest in Africa and most of the third world. This to us is no longer news. We must break new ground. Your Excellency, ladies and gentlemen, through the vision of one Robert Gabriel Mugabe, the Presidential Commission of Inquiry into Education and Training, or SEAT, was established in 1998 under the chairmanship of Dr. Kaifas Kuzira Masanga. While there have been some implementation successes, the SEAT report has not been fully implemented, certainly on my side of the ministry. Chief among the omissions has been a comprehensive curriculum review synchronized with a teacher optimization program to equip teachers with the knowledge, attitudes, orientation, and skills to usher in support avenues for the new curriculum. The goal is clear: the acquisition of productive and functional skills among all our learners, irrespective of socioeconomic placement and class location in our society. School learners in the region of 4.5 million currently must make a telling contribution to the socioeconomic development of our country. The ministry has prioritized this direction. The comprehensive curriculum mini review that's coming up and its implementation as a preparatory phase and as an ongoing rubric of our work, we must underpin and anticipate a new emphasis with a teaching cadre that has the competences to take learners to the intended heights of learning. Hence today's launch of the Teacher Capacity Development Program, or simply put, the Teacher Optimization Platform. But we must work with what human and material resources we have in the system. A glimpse into the sector shows the following trends. We still have teachers at T4 at around 253 in the system. At T3, I hope that those statistics can be flashed on the screen. At T3, 1,100. Yes, I can see they are trying. And then T2, at 65 of these teachers we still have. STC, about 100 of those. And then PTH, primary teacher, but higher level. 122, and we have those that hold degrees that are not necessarily in education. Master of Science, the icon, the thinker, founder and pillar of Zimbabwe's post-independence education system. This teacher capacity development program you are about to launch, Your Excellency, does put you in good standing, this does put the teachers in good standing with existing appointment and advancement criteria for teachers and other officers in the service. Professional qualifications are particularly not only in the eyes of the ministry, but in the eyes as well, the Civil Service Commission represented today by one of its commissioners, who have graced this occasion